Assalamu alaikum wa marhaban wa ahlan wa sahlan bikum. Peace and hello and welcome to another lesson about days in the week. But hold on, if you know them even, it's a good idea to watch till the very end of the video because we're going to discuss how to use them in practical ways, that is when you're speaking about your appointments and your agenda and so on, plus some practical tips to help you remember them better. So stick around, stay till the very end of the video. Ayyam al-usbu'. Ayyam is the plural of yawm. Usbu'a is a week, hence ayyam al-usbu'a, days of the week. We're going to actually start with the work week. So if you want to start with Sunday, Sunday is al-ahad. And you might know that wahid is one, hence al-ahad is the first day, but we're using the work week all over here. So al-ithnain is the second day, and you might know ithnan is number two, so hence al-ithnain, which is literally the second day of the week. And in like if we're speaking about a school week or a work week, we normally begin with al-ithnain. Just remember that it comes from the number two, and that's a tip to help you remember. Thalatha is three. Al-thulatha, and that's actually from number three. Al-thulatha, Tuesday. Arba'a means four, so we have al-arba'a. Al-arba'a, Wednesday. Khamsa is five, and that's why we have al-khamis, al-khamis. Al-jum'a or al-jum'a, both are acceptable, so you can pronounce it either way. Al-jum'a or al-jum'a with dhamma over here. And that would be number six, but it's not relevant in terms of pronunciation. Accept, and you might recognize sabah starts with a scene, accept starts with a scene. So that's just a little tip. Accept sabah. And going back to al ahad, which is Sunday, that comes from wahid. You might know, for example, in the holy book of the Quran, قل هو الله أحد. So he's the one and only. Ahad means one. So al ahad. So if we look at the working week, al-ithnain, al-thulatha, al-arba'a, al-khamis, wal-jum'a, the weekend, we call it utlatu nihayat al-usbu'. Utla is literally a holiday, utla. Nihaya is end or ending when you're reading a book or watching a movie. An-nihaya, the end. So utlatu nihayat al-usbu' literally means the vacation of the end of the week, so the weekend. Al-sabt wal-ahad is the weekend. That's generally speaking. Obviously different countries have their different weekends. If you travel to Arabic countries, some of them might have Jum'ah wal-sabt as in their official holiday instead of al-sabt wal-ahad. Some vocabulary. So yawm is a day, ayyam, days, usbu', week, asabi', weeks, al-ithnain, al-thulatha, al-arbi'a, al-khamis, al-jum'a, al-sabt, al-ahad. Utla is a vacation, or it could mean your day off as well. What's a diary called in Arabic? Mudhakkira or mufakkira. So they both basically mean the same thing. So diary, mudhakkira or mufakkira. And actually in Arabic, they both mean something that reminds you, a reminder. So mudhakkira also means a memo. So if you're having a meeting, mudhakkiratul ijtima', the memo for the meeting. Jadwal, schedule, it's similar. Schedule jadwal. That means literally a schedule. Ruznama is a calendar and sometimes taqweem as well. For example, al-taqweem al-miladi wa taqweem al-hijri. So you have the normal calendar that we follow in like everywhere. And we have the, for example, the hijri or Islamic calendar. And rusnama is actually what you would hang on the wall or have to refer to the date. So that's what we call rusnama. Mawa'id is an appointment. Mawa'id in the plural is appointment. So jadwal al-mawa'id is the schedule of appointments. Jadwal al-a'mal is the schedule of business work, literally. Jadwal al-a'mal, the things that you have to do, al-a'mal. Practical example, a text. For example, over here, you have the schedule, study schedule, al-jadwal al-dirasi. Dirasa means study or studying. Dirasi, literally like you're saying, scholar. You have the ya of attribution at the end, the suffix, like when you say, ana lubnani. Yani, ana min lubnan. Lubnan, lubnani. Dirasa, dirasi. Islam, islami, islamic. So you have the ya of attribution at the end, it's just the suffix. So al-jadwal al-dirasi, literally the scholar, schedule. Hissa is a session, literally. Al-hissa al-ula, al-hissa al-thaniya, al-hissa al-thalitha, al-hissa al-rabi'a. First session, second session, third session, fourth session. Al-dirasatu khamsatu ayyamin fil usbu'. Studying is 5 days in the week. That's the normal, schedule that everyone has. Yawm al-ithnayn. So the day of Monday, wa yawm al-thulatha, wa yawm al-arbi'a, wa yawm al-khamis, wa yawm al-jum'a. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Obviously, you can omit yawm, you can say al-ithnayn, al-thulatha, al-arbi'a, al-khamis, wa al-jum'a. Al-utlatu yawm al-sabt. The holiday or the vacation or the day off is Saturday and the day of Sunday. Yawm al-sabt wa yawm al-ahad. المواد الدراسية, so scholarly subject. مادة in the singular, مواد in the plural. So you have اللغة العربية, Arabic language, الرياضيات, that means math. And sometimes we call it الحساب because like calculating or calculus, الحساب. Not رياضة, be careful, رياضة is sports, رياضة with التاء المربوطة is sports. Let me write it down for you. Riyada is actually sports. Riyadiyat is math. Al-ulum, science. You might know ilm is knowledge as well. Ulum means science. Al-hasub is computer. Al-kimia, chemistry. Al-fizya, physics. Al-tariikh, history. Al Geographia, geography. So it sounds similar to English, some of them. Tarikh means history. And also when you're asking about the date, ما تاريخ اليوم? What's today's date? You're also using tarikh. You can see الحصة الأولى حاسوب. يوم الاثنين الحصة الأولى حاسوب. الحصة الثانية هي العلوم. الحصة الثالثة هي اللغة العربية. الحصة الرابعة هي الرياضيات. يوم الثلاثياء الثلاثاء عفوا الحصة الأولى هي كيمياء, ثم الحصة الثانية هي فيزياء, ثم الحصة الثالثة هي لغة عربية, and so on. So you have here a schedule, جدول الحصص, a schedule for the sessions. You can actually write your own. What you study every day, try to learn the new subjects in Arabic. جدول المواعيد, schedule for appointments. Have a look, okay, and let me know what appointments are on each day. ما المواعيد في هذا الأسبوع? What are the appointments in this week? يوم الاثنين Monday عندي طبيب أسنان for example I have a dentist أو سأزور طبيب الأسنان يوم الثلاثاء عندي غداء وعمل مع المدير I have a business lunch with the manager يوم الأربعاء عندي تمرين في النادي الرياضي So I have literally training or exercise in the sports gym. And nadi is a gym or club. Riyadi means sport, like sporty or sportive, literally. We're using again the suffix over here. يوم الخميس سأذهب إلى السينما مع أصدقائي. I'm going to go to the movies. يوم الجمعة سأصلي صلاة الجمعة. So I'm going to do the prayer of Friday, for example, في المسجد. ثم سأذهب لزيارة خالتي. And then I'm going to go to visit my maternal aunt. يوم السبت سأذهب في نزهة إلى شاطئ البحر. Saturday I'm going to go for a stroll or an outing to the beach, شاطئ البحر. والسفر سيكون يوم الأحد. Travel is going to be on Sunday. So, يوم الأحد سأسافر إلى باريس. I'm gonna go to Paris. Okay, complete the sentences over here. So you can pause actually and complete the sentences to practice. هذا كان كل شيء. That was everything for this very short and brief lesson. درس قصير ومختصر very short and brief أراكم إن شاء الله في الفيديو القادم don't forget to leave your comments below and to subscribe to the channel if you haven't شكرا لكم ومع السلامة